Good morning. It's Monday, January 28th, 2013. My name's Stephen Whiteside, and I'm your host this morning for today's edition of Canadian Stock Market Trends. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures and commodities are flat, so we are looking for a quiet open at 9:30 Monday morning. We'll talk about quiet out there. There's a storm going on right now, but in the futures, I was just listening to my friend on 680 News say that Dow futures were up $3 while crude oil was down 3 cents and gold was down $3. So very quiet out there in the pre-market this morning. Still a couple of hours to go before the market opens, so things could change. Let's start off this morning, take a look at some weekly charts, starting with the weekly panic zone chart for the TSX. Of course, last time we saw low-risk buying opportunity was back here. We're down at the bottom of the panic zones, had a pressure zone forming. Things started to turn around. We started to move back up. Had a couple of early warning signals, saw a pullback, started to move back up. Currently ranked at 10 on a scale of 0 to 10, so we're up at the top of the range. Still projecting slightly higher prices here, so we could continue to move higher, but we are up at resistance. We're up at, this is again a weekly chart, and so both on our daily and weekly chart, we're looking at 12,800, 1250 as a mathematical target. Of course, the market doesn't look at the little numbers, the 1250. They look at the big numbers. 12,800 would be the big round number they would use. And so back here in 2011, that area became support. Moving forward in 2012, that became resistance. And now here we are in 2013, we're up at 12,800, 1250 as our resistance target. And so this is the time and place where long-term investors would want to lock in some profits. We've had a nice move over the past couple of months, and the only way you're going to get to keep any of that money is if you sell into strength. And so here we are, we're on a nice quiet Monday morning. And if you're a long-term investor and you're watching the weekly charts, it would be pretty prudent of you to put in some sell orders this morning and lock in some profits. You do not have to completely liquidate your holdings, but now's the time and place to lock them in while things are quiet. The VIX is continuing to trend lower. That's good for the long-term outlook of the stock market, so that hasn't changed. Financial services, which is one of the sectors leading the Canadian stock market higher, we're up at levels that we've seen back in 2011. Of course, those people who bought up in that area during RSP season, of course, they're pretty angry that they had to endure all this time before the market came back to where it is now. So here we are up at those levels. And if you have been investing in financial stocks, you do not have to completely liquidate your position, but it might be very prudent for you to lock in some profits at this time. Now, if you're following gold and precious metal stocks, of course, the world is going in a completely different direction. We had a small daily buy signal the other day, which was quickly reversed, and now we're heading lower once again. We're down at the recent range, but if we break through the recent lows that we've had in 2012, the lows from 2008 are way down at 153.03. And so there is lots of mathematical support there, but you know, the last time we had real panic selling was back in 2008, and I certainly hope that does not happen. So if we take out the recent lows, our next mathematical target for the TSX Gold Index is 250. Now, gold stocks are in two different camps. You've got the gold stocks that broke down a long time ago, and every time that they have a rally, people sell in to those rallies, and so Kinross is one of those gold stocks. What you want to focus on, of course, are the ones that people are buying the dips, and so you've got companies like Yamana, and I'll do a presentation and focus on the winners and losers in the gold sector probably Monday or Tuesday. But if you take a look at a weekly chart of Yamana, you can see that people continue to buy the dip and use the flypaper channel as support, whereas a stock like Kinross, the flypaper channel is resistance and people sell any rally. So two different camps, two different types of gold stocks. So even with the TSX Gold Index down at these recent lows, there are some stocks that people are still following and buying on any dip, and Yamana is one of them. Okay, so for long-term investors, we've had a nice run in the market. We're up at resistance. There is no guarantee that hitting this resistance is going to stop the market dead in its tracks. But if you want to lock in any of these profits that you've made over the past few months, and now's the time to do it. It's a nice quiet day on Monday. There's no fear in the market. The TSX is not opening down 300 points, so you're not selling into weakness. You're selling into strength, and today would be a good day to do that. Next up, let's take a look at the daily charts, and starting with volatility. Volatility is going to be something we're going to be buying soon. Just don't know when that day is. Obviously, with the futures really quiet in the pre-market on Monday, we're not expecting it to happen on Monday. But for the S&P 500 VIX, we're looking for a daily close above 1370. For the VIX for the TSX 60, we're looking for a daily close above 1343. For the TSX itself, you can see that we're up at the top of the panic zones, currently ranked at 10. We're running into resistance, as I mentioned earlier, at 12,812.50. We've had a nice run up since early December. We've been up two lines. That's a typical move for a market. We had a bearish reversal day on Friday, so we'll have to see if we get fall through to the downside on Monday. Take a look at the energy sector. We moved up on Friday, stuck at resistance up here at 257.81. If you look back in 2012, you can see that that was an area of support for the TSX Energy Index. And so, of course, what was previously support is now going to act as resistance. And so here we are stuck at the 257.81 level. Looking at financial services stocks, they moved up on Friday but actually had a bearish reversal day, so came off their highs and reversed, and so we're looking to see if we get fall through to the downside on Monday. Gold stocks, of course, recently made a lower high and now a lower low, and of course that continues with the bearish story for the gold sector. Looking at telecom services, they reversed off the recent high there, and we were looking for a move up to 114.08, got as high as 114.06, so pretty darn close on Friday, and reversed off that resistance area. And looking at the venture exchange, continued to move lower on Friday, so we're on a sell signal for the microcap venture exchange. Taking a look at commodities on Monday morning, coming into Monday, we've got copper just on the edge of a new sell signal. Really, any lower close on Monday would give us a new sell signal for copper. Saw fall through to the downside for gold on Friday. Saw fall through to the downside for silver. Silver is now back on a sell signal and broke down below the moving average convergence. Looking at the energy sector, inside day for crude oil on Friday, gasoline continued to move higher, natural gas moved lower. A close below 338.40 on Monday would give us a new daily sell signal for natural gas. Next up, let's take a look at my six stocks, and no trend changes today to worry about, but let's just take a look at what I see when I open my portfolio. Now, this is the way it looks when I open it up, and it comes up in symbol order here. And what I can do is I can sort it, of course. I can just click on the number one up here and sort that column. And so Agrium, of course, is still at the top, both mathematically and alphabetically. But down at the bottom here, we get down to Goldcorp. Now, this is a ranking between 0 and 10. And the numbers are related to themselves. They're not related to each other. So that's important to remember. And so a stock that is ranked at 10, we usually expect to see it up in the top right-hand corner of the screen. And a stock anything below 3, we expect to see it down at the bottom right-hand corner of the screen. That is not always the case because, again, these numbers are relevant to the individual symbol and not to each other. So let's just go take a quick scan through here. Agrium currently ranked at 10, so we expect that up in the top right-hand corner of the screen, and that's just where it is. Very far away from getting a sell signal on Monday, so not really anything to worry about. We also have this open gap here that could potentially act as support on the way back down. Hopefully you've locked in some profits. We ran into another profit target on Friday. So hopefully you've already locked in some profits and Don't have to worry about a big pullback. Bank of Montreal ranked at 10, again up at the top of the panic zones, up at the top right-hand corner of the screen. Inside day on Friday, not worried about a sell signal on Monday. Hopefully you've locked in profits here. We're up at resistance at 64.06 on the daily charts and 64.06 on the weekly charts, and that takes us back to our high from RSP season back in 2011. So the people who bought back there, kind of anxious to get their money back and are happy sellers up at this level. And that can restrict the amount of enthusiasm we see for a stock like this up at these prices. Taking a look at WestJet, up at the top of the panic zones, of course, we expect to see it up at the top right-hand corner. It's still holding up. It's had early warning signals, had a bearish reversal. Still, the stock is holding up and has not been down to the lower channel line recently, so that's still a good thing. 21.88 was our target on our daily chart. We've started to trade slightly above it. It's also our weekly target up at the top of our projected range for WestJet. And so while we've traded above 21.88, we haven't broken away from it on either the daily or weekly chart. Looking at Encana, currently ranked a 5. Obviously, this is a very beaten down stock, and the number is related to its activity and not to the other stocks' activity. Currently on a buy signal right now, moved up slightly on Friday. Not expecting a lot from this stock at the present time. Alumina copper continues to move lower. We're up at the top of the panic zones, early warning signal. You can see, when we had pressure zones, that was the time to look at buying the stock. We don't have a pressure zone just yet, so still expecting the stock to move lower. There's a nice open gap down here right at this point, and so wouldn't be surprised to see the stock move down to try to fill that open gap. There's an open gap right here that's currently holding the stock in check. But since we're not expecting a lot from this sector right now and expecting copper to continue to move lower, wouldn't be surprised if we got right back down to this level in the not-so-distant future. Things, of course, would change for aluminum copper on Monday with a daily close above 980. Last up, taking a look at Goldcorp, you can see the elongated pressure zone that we had here, which is telling us that this stock has lost its rhythm and is currently not cycling the way it was before, so it's a broken stock. Again, currently ranked a 2 down at the bottom right-hand corner here, and currently on a sell signal. A daily close above 37.25 would give us a buy signal on Monday. Not expecting to see that. Last up this morning, quick look at some 60-minute charts. I was still looking for the VIX to break out above 13. That would be negative for the stock market. For the TSX, the middle of the flypaper channel right now is at 12,700. So a pullback into that area wouldn't be surprising. A little more strength in energy stocks right now. Financial services still holding up. Of course, what's heading in the wrong direction is anything in the precious metals area or mining. First sign of strength on Monday is going to be an hourly close above 12,835. If the TSX can do that on Monday, that would certainly brighten things up, but not expecting that to happen at this point. Okay, that's all for Monday morning, folks. Long-term investors trading with weekly charts are probably going to want to lock in some profits right now. You don't have to completely liquidate a position, but I would certainly be looking at liquidating at least 50% of it right now on this nice, quiet Monday morning. Have a great day, and I'll talk to you again next on Tuesday morning.